trying to be artsy behind this curtain like this. I'm starting this morning shot behind the curtain because I am totally naked. And I'm late. It's 6:45. I'm supposed to be at Animal Kingdom at 7 a.m. for early magic hours, which is where hotel guests get to use the parks before non-hotel guests come in. So usually it's quieter, you can get more rides, and I've overslept. So I'm very naked, I've ironed, I need to shower, and I need to get going to Animal Kingdom.
Last night I had a bit of an incident. I dropped this in Walmart, and it was in my bag, and I didn't think anything of it until I got out of my Uber, and the boot stank of alcohol. Yes, I've broken a couple of bottles, so I've popped a little note this morning to say be careful, because there is some glass and stuff. Oh no, what have I done? Some glass and stuff inside. Oh, get in there.
Well, slightly later than planned, because it's 7:20, and Animal Kingdom opened at 7, and the plan was to be there for Flight of Passage, because that queue can get 3 hours long. Maybe more sometimes. That was the plan anyway, to get to Flight of Passage. Not quite happened. I do have a fast pass for later though, so we'll be going on it. You can't come with me, I'm afraid. There's no filming on this ride. Plus you wouldn't see anything anyway, because it's all 3D. So I'm gonna head off now. I might grab a coffee on the way, because I'm feeling a little bit tired. I'm not sure I've caught up with the jet lag. So off to Animal Kingdom.
A delicious day today in Florida. Many thanks, I'll have that. I'm just going now. I'm gonna go get coffee first of all, and then I shall head down to the bus to Animal Kingdom. It's not actually that far, Animal Kingdom, so I should be there very soon, but just look how beautiful it is around here. It's so, so nice. And I appreciate it is, what, 7 o'clock in the morning, 7:15, but it's still so beautifully quiet. I love it.
Good morning and welcome to Disney's Animal Kingdom. So we're in Animal Kingdom, and most people take a left when they get into the park. Right down in front of me is the Tree of Life, and once you get there, take another left, and that takes you to Pandora, the world of Avatar.
There it is, the Tree of Life at Animal Kingdom. Right, let's head off to Pandora.
So once you come past the Tree of Life, take another left, and then head on down this way, which right at the bottom is the entrance to Pandora, the world of Avatar, and the Flight of Passage, which is the best ride in Disney. I can't even begin to prepare you on how beautiful you're gonna find Avatar, but we're just literally just going in. We've just come over the bridge back there, which takes you in from the main Animal Kingdom entrance into Avatar. Take a look at this, it's beautiful. What I love about this floor, it looks like some child has gone mad with some chalk, but at night this all glows and it looks absolutely beautiful.
Thank you. We call it a banshee.
Okay, so I let you know, I am very new to piloting utilities. And I'm back today, I'm doing my final solo trip off Monday. And I've got all these tests, I can wear this suit. I'm going to be here all this.
This is a night blossom. It was $6.99. I have no idea what it is, and I have no idea what this is. I'm going to get it high. Pears, limes, and strawberry, I think. It's very refreshing. Oh my goodness, Flight of Passage was amazing. It is by far the best ride on Disney property, not just in Animal Kingdom, across the whole four parks, for sure. It's absolutely amazing. I did feel a tiny bit motion sickness this time around. I didn't last time I'd done it. But the sights, the smells, and everything. Disney, good job. Welcome to Dinorama. I've got fast passes for Dinosaur. Not this one, the actual ride, which is this way. So I'm gonna head over there now. Just a normal fairground, if you look at this. And there's some stuff, a primeval world over there is brilliant. But it's kind of themed. Whichever it is, Dinosaur Land. It's pretty cool. Disney's Dinosaur Ride. Anybody remember the film? No. This dinosaur's going, huh? What? Here we go. Let's go on Dinosaur. Come off Dinosaur. I do love that ride. The whole purpose of the ride is that you're supposed to be tracking this dinosaur and you're trying to kind of rescue it and bring it out, and you go past various different dinosaurs on the way. And every time we went past the dinosaur, which wasn't the one we were supposed to catch, there was a man behind me going, nope, and then we get to another one and go, nope, and then we got to the end and he was like, that's not it. So thank you for making the ride. It was hilarious. Right, let's go get some breakfast. We're going under. You've got to love Disney. It's 10 to 10 in the morning, and I can't seem to get breakfast anywhere. But you can get a pint of Bud Light, if you fancy that for breakfast. Actually, it's looking more and more like an option, to be honest with you. This right here is where they have the Rivers of Light show, which is of an evening. It's quite a nice little show. Not the best nighttime show that they've ever done. It's the only one that they have here at Animal Kingdom. They've made a few changes to it recently as well. So I haven't actually seen it since they made a few changes. I don't know whether they've made it better or worse. Who knows? But this is where it is. A little bit later on the scene. I think times vary, but it's normally when it gets about dark 8 or 9 o'clock at night. There's supposed to be monkeys in here somewhere. I see no monkeys. Do you see any monkeys? Some baby ducks instead. Cute. Where are the monkeys? So I managed to find somewhere to eat Yak and Yeti for breakfast. It seems to be the only place open, but actually look at this. That looks really amazing. There is some, there's some bit of cheese, some scrambled eggs, some breakfast potatoes. Over here, hash browns, and this is a sausage and egg muffin. So we've just come out of Pandora, which is that way, through in towards Harambe for the Festival of the Lion King. Let's go check it out.
Boy, let's settle down for the last time.
just finished up at Festival of the Lion King, which you've got to go and see if you come here. It's really, really good. The amusing thing, or slightly annoying thing, was the bloke that was sat next to me had obviously seen the show like hundreds of times and was announcing everything about 5 seconds before it was due to happen, so kind of ruined it a little bit. But hey, I'm sure he's enjoying it. Anyway, it's a great show. Go and check it out. The Festival of the Lion King, if you come to Animal Kingdom. In the room, it's about 2:15. This looks like I'm on the loo, doesn't it? I'm not. Let me just show you what I'm doing. I'm just splish splashing the feet. Look at them. Horrible things, look at them. Ugh. Anyway, I've got bites and blisters and everything going on, so I'm just having a lovely cool down by soaking my feet in the bath and having a beer. Cheers. So I've been Animal Kingdom all morning, so I got there about 8. It was really busy today. So I actually got Flight Passage twice, had one fast pass and queued for the other one. Dinosaur twice, Cali River Rapids, which I got a little bit wet on, not too much. Had a bit of a wander round, had a really nice breakfast. And now I've just come back to the room, waited ages for a bus back to Port Orleans. It was quite a wait. It was about 25 minutes, and then it takes about 50 minutes to get here, so it's coming up to an hour waiting to sort of get back. I'm gonna chill for a few hours, probably have a shower because I'm a bit sweaty, drink some more beer, and then tonight I'm heading to Hollywood Studios for a little bit. That closes at 9 and Magic Kingdom's open till midnight, so I might go to Magic Kingdom afterwards. I'll see how I'm feeling. Still coping with the jet lag. But we'll see, but I'm going to have a rest for a little bit now, after I've sorted my feet out. Well, like, for the first time ever, I don't actually know how to get into Hollywood Studios. It's changed so much. There's a lot of work going on at the moment. There's all the construction of Star Wars, and there's also the Skyliner as well. So the entrance for the buses is way back there. And the entrance to the park is way over here. It's all changed because it used to kind of just be sort of over here. So it's a long old trekkie. Hey,
you have a bag.
Look at that.
So just about to ride Alien Space Rangers something. Should have probably worked out what it was called before I told you. This little lot was $30, so this is scampi or prawns, a couple of chicken goujon-y things, and some chips. Tiny little bit of coleslaw. This is a watermelon margarita, so that would have put the price up by about, I think, $13, I guess. But yeah, that lot came to $30, which is about £27. Luckily, because I'm on the meal plan, that cost me zilcho. No pounds, which is included in my hotel stay. So, worth the money for that, but would I pay 27 quid for that?
I'm just gonna give this a little go. Yep, that's a margarita for sure. Oh, I do have the measures over here.
Cheers.
It's amazing, look at this. The Pixar down the side, Toy Story in there. And then, Toys Don't Tell No Tales, which is a play on Pirates of the Caribbean, and this side is a play on Haunted Mansion. Love it. $16.99. This needs to come home with me immediately. Look at that, love it. So, back at the hotel now. I had a lush day today, actually. Started off quite early with Animal Kingdom, lots done there. Went over to Hollywood Studios for this evening. That was really nice. Got to see Toy Storyland for the first time, which is just brilliant. They do such a good job. Went on the Alien Swirling Saucers, that's one of the new rides, that was really good as well. And I got to meet two characters that I've never met before, which was Mike and Sully from Monsters, Inc. So that was amazing. And literally had the best hug ever. Lush. Busy day today. So back in the room, I've got ice hockey on. I've no idea what's going on. I'm going to watch that. And I'm going to chill out. And I got myself one of these, which is a peanut butter banana Mickey chocolate bar. It says that's three servings. It won't be. So that's it for today. Join me next time. If you like what you saw, you can leave a lovely comment below. Pop us a like as well. And if you didn't like it, then share it anyway. And lots of other people could dislike it as well. See you next time.